This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to one of our large and common bottomland hardwood species, and that's Eastern Cottonwood. Eastern Cottonwood species name is Populus deltoides, and it gets that name from the delta shape of the leaves that you can see here. So very triangular or delta shape. The leaf arrangement on Eastern Cottonwood is alternate, and it has simple leaves on long flattened leaf stems that allow the leaves to flutter in the wind, as do the related aspens. Eastern Cottonwood has relatively prominent teeth on the margin of the leaves that actually can look a little bit hooked, almost like a saw blade. The stems will be green during the growing season, then darken to kind of a medium tan color, and oftentimes are somewhat angular, and it will have very large extended buds at the end of the twigs toward the end of the growing season. Eastern Cottonwood gets to be a very large tree because of its rapid growth rate, and another great characteristic for this species is the long running ridges that are very strong and prominent up and down the stem. Kind of a medium gray brown. This species also gets to be very large and tall in moist river bottoms, well over 100 feet in height, sometimes 3 to 4 feet in diameter. Not particularly long lived, maybe 150 years or less, but it makes up for that lack of age with very fast growth rate. Cottonwood is well named. Its fruit that's produced earlier in the season is a little tuft of white hairs that holds a small seed that can blow away from the parent tree and populate almost any place where we've got bare exposed soils, but particularly stream bottoms and other areas where there's flooding and new soil is created. Eastern cottonwood, relatively weak wooded, so maybe not the best choice for a yard tree, and also because of that cottony seed production, some people find that a little bit disagreeable. It produces them in large numbers. But nonetheless, a very important bottomland species that shades our streams, holds the soil in place on our river bottoms, and provides some additional diversity to our Indiana forests.